Is it possible to make a little 4-inch glide bait that sinks like a countdown? So this guy will fall 1 foot for every 1 second you count. Is it possible? Will it actually glide and make the movement have the action that I want? That is what we're finding out today. But first, I need to make this guy. And this guy definitely humbled me. This is about my 4th lure ever made. And I was feeling great going into this. And everything went wrong. Absolutely everything. From the paint scheme I wanted to my airbrush not working. It just stopped working on me. So I had to tear that all apart. While I did mess up quite a bit on this lure, it taught me a lot of stuff about lure making, so that is good. I do not regret making this lure. Will it work? Let's go find out. But first, we need to make this guy. So let's jump back to yesterday and start making this lure.
Check out that catfish.
Are you freaking kidding me right
now? All right, so today we are making a walleye. I caught some walleye the other day and it inspired me to make one. So this is our little walleye bait. I'm not gonna be painting a realistic scheme. I actually want to do a fire tiger paint scheme because I know fire tiger works really well at my local lake. So that's what we're doing. Let's cut this out. So another thing too is I also want to do kind of like a countdown lure where it drops a foot every second. So I will have to balance out the weight just perfectly to make that happen. But that is because I fish a very deep reservoir and I need this guy to sink down deep where the fish are. There is our shape. Let's go cut her out. So I just sanded this down with some P60 sandpaper. Just got rid of all the little cut marks and everything, made it all smooth. So I got the front line tie hole drilled out and also went ahead and cut the tail slot for the fin to sit in. I'm just gonna go ahead and sand that down a little bit, clean that up. So I think we need at least one segment. Just so it has a little bit of a swim action. If not, it's just gonna fart through the water like that. Where do we want it though? The fins stop there. All right, so this is where our segment is going to be. Just one right there. Should give it some action. Stop there because I still have to carve everything and sand it. I don't want to go through all the way. That will tell me where to cut it later on. But now I need to draw the edge lines, get those carved and sand it down. If that's the tail thickness, which honestly may be too thick, but it's all I can do. I need that wood right here to keep the tail fin in. So I may just have to keep this as wide as it is. All right, there is our lines. It's gonna be kind of thick. It's a thick boy, but again, it needs to be for this tail slot. I don't wanna go past that tail slot. I guess I could. No, that wouldn't look good. I'm gonna carve down just a hair, but really it's not much. Not much I need to take off this guy. That you turd. Oh my gosh, are you kidding me? It's like it's picking off. No, I mean, oh, that sucks. Like I said, I needed this extra wood there and it just chipped off completely. It still left wood there. I mean, I can maybe work with it, but sketchy, man. All right, carving, not fun. We're gonna have to sand this guy. Alright, I got all that sanded down. I definitely did not want to go that thin on the back. I did not plan that at all, but the wood chipped on me. So we had to, but we'll make it work, dang it. It's the last thing I do. Now we need to draw our edge lines. Let's see. Alright, I cannot afford to have it chip on me anymore down here. Have to be super careful. We can go ahead and finish cutting these segment lines here. All right, so with this swim bait here, I want to cut some slots right in here, 1 and 2, and then drill a hole. I already got that hole started right there, but I will then push a pin through there. All right, so I just screwed that piece up bad. I may be able to salvage it, but yeah, that did not go as planned. I'm just gonna go ahead and connect some hardware in here. I did round off these edges though, kind of around this piece right in there. That way it doesn't get caught on anything, hopefully. And that will maybe let it swim just a little bit wider. But yeah, that was a big fail right there. First time trying it. I need to do it on way bigger swim baits, not this little bitty one. But I also went and got the right wire. I've been talking about the right wire for a while now, and I actually got some. So lock wire, this is the 0.041 stainless steel. So we can now make really good looking hardware. Look at that beautiful line tie. Oh my gosh, first freaking try. I was using paper clips and it took me like 3 tries to like barely even get it, not even this good. So that's my first attempt with the right wire. Oh, so much freaking better. That is the importance of having the right materials. I'm gonna go ahead and seal the ends of these pieces so we don't have to worry about it later. I also just filled that hole up, so we are ready to put the hardware in place on this back end. All right, so here is our bait. Before I stick these two together permanently, which, the glue may have stuck. Crap. There we go. There was still a little bit of glue in there. But before I permanently stick these together, I need to make the fins and the tail. I got some Lexan here. Now that I'm thinking about how small these are, I probably should have just kept them in the wood. Oops. But we definitely need the tail. Alright, I'm just gonna cut out the tail with this Lexan, not the fins. That's probably real hard to see it, but there's a tail right in there. We got that piece cut out. I'm gonna go ahead and use a Dremel and put some lines on that tail. Carve some detail. Honestly, with a little swim bait this small, I probably should have just made the tail out of the wood. Wouldn't have added that much buoyancy to it, but oh well. We did it this way. All right, so there is all the grooves that added into the tail. That's just some minor details. I need to go ahead and drill all the hook tie slots. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and seal this bait. Cover it in super glue. Just mixed up some epoxy here. Put that on my line tie and shove it in the hole. I say we go ahead and get this back line tie in as well. I'm shooting some super glue inside there before I epoxy it, just so it stays and hardens quicker than this epoxy will. Epoxy might take a minute and I don't want it to move on me while the epoxy is hardening, so. Got the two front line ties on. That is complete. I still need to drill out the hole for the weight, which I already got it started, but we also need to get some weight in this guy. We do not have much room to work with here. Started poking through the backside. So to add the weight to this back end, as you can see, it is a very tiny piece. I drilled the hole all the way through, and then I just stuck one of these drop shot weights that is a cylinder. I cut it down to size and dropped it right inside that hole. Will that be enough weight? I don't know, but that is probably the most weight I can get into it without a lead pot. I need to get a lead pot. I'm gonna go ahead and fill up these holes, get it back to looking pretty. I got that all sanded down after adding the weight. Now I need to add this treble hook, line tie. Same thing, super glue and epoxy. Weight up here. I'm gonna start with the same size I put in back. This will probably need more, but that's okay. If it does, we will add more. I got the rings and the treble hooks attached. Let's drop it in some water, see how it floats. Oh, it goes down pretty quick. It falls tail first too. All right, so I'm drilling out some of this weight in the back. I'm gonna go nice and slow until we get it the right amount. That's barely anything, honestly, but I'm gonna keep doing that until it sits perfectly. I pretty much dug out all the weight in that back. We barely needed any, but it now falls perfectly level. And the action, I can already tell it's gonna work, so pretty freaking awesome. I'm gonna go ahead and fill up this hole here that we made for the weight. Like I said, I pretty much took it all back out. Just got the eye sockets drilled out. I think we're ready for paint. So like I said, I want to paint this a fire tiger color. We got bright green, bright yellow, orange, and maybe some white. Probably not much white, but we will need some black as well. So I'm about to start painting the lure. I'm gonna start with a darker green for darker green scales. It is time for scales. I went ahead and painted the lure a lighter green. I've experimented with a bunch of shit, bunch of stuff, and all my bright colors that I've been wanting to use are all transparent, and they look horrible without being painted on white. So that's kind of out of the picture. So what I'm going to do is just go with green scales, a white bait, and then we'll kind of go from there. I'm not really sure. I painted some of the orange that looked like crap. It looks like a dark brown over the green. It does not look good. Alright, so I just drew a template for the black marks I want on this bait. Those guys may come down a bit too far. I think I'm gonna go for it. I was gonna do the fire tiger as well, guys, but I gave up on that because I do not have the right color or the right opaque colors, I guess. All my colors are transparent and it looks like crap, so I'm going to add some black to this. And that's probably it, honestly. So it's still kind of a fire tiger pattern. It just doesn't have the orange, the yellow, just green and black. All right, so here is the lure with the black added. I wasn't too sure how I felt about the black, but it's slowly growing on me. It kind of looks like a Frankenstein something. I don't know. It's looking good though. Now it is time to add some eyes. You can barely see that eye, but it is there. I really want to clean up this black, but the freaking every time I use black in my airbrush, it bursts. It doesn't spray a continuous spray, it bursts. And I don't know why. I'm using reducer, you know, I'm doing everything I think I should be doing. But for some reason, it just does not want to work with black. So yeah, it made doing this last part very hard. And it did not come out the best, but I painted the bottom white to paint it orange, but I'm just gonna leave it like this. That's it. That's done. What do y'all think? Let me know in the comments. I'm gonna go ahead and do a top coat, and if I want to add anything else to it, I can do it on top of that. I'm just mixing some 5-minute epoxy. That is going to be our top coat. That top coat shine though. Looks pretty good. All right, it is the next day and the epoxy has dried somewhat. It's still a little wet, but we can touch it. It did drip quite a bit on this piece. It was sitting upside down like this. And you can kind of tell it flared out on these ends here. I need to get a rotator so it can constantly rotate and have it even spread, but I don't have one yet. I need to make one, but we are ready to glue this bad boy together. Can drop some super glue down inside there. All right, the finished product looks freaking awesome, man. I really dig the black and green. All right, here is the bait in the sun. Like I said, the black, it was being really hard to work with. It was not spray right. And if you look, it almost kind of shows through some green, but that looks really good. It's hard to kind of see on camera. It almost looks like a green sparkle. But there is the bait in the sun. I really love this green on the tail. It is so freaking bright. Definitely have to use that green some more in future baits. But all right, let's go fishing. Tie this bad boy on. And guess what, guys? Another windy day. Oh, I can never win out here. This is a, if you're a fisherman, this is not the location to be.
again, super windy. Here's some calm water in the boat slip. Check out the action. The tail is still kind of heavy, man. I probably shouldn't have even added weight to the tail. Has like a... first cast. And I'm gonna let this guy sink. That is what we want. It sucks because I make lures on crappy weather days. And that's when the fishing is not good. So, I mean, I get done with the lure and the fishing is crap because the weather's crap. Sheesh. Why is it so windy?
All right, guys, so my final verdict for this lure is it does have decent action, but you glide baits are supposed to suspend like 6 inches in the water. And I made this glide bait to be a countdown where it sinks a foot every second. And that kind of kills the action. It is too heavy. If I built this guy to suspend a few inches from the surface, it would have freaking glided perfectly like it did in the tub. But yeah, it's just a glide bait is not supposed to sink. So that was kind of a fail on my part. But hey, I tried it. I'm happy I tried it. We learned from it. I've learned a lot of stuff about lure making from this video, so I am happy I made this lure. But also, this is kind of the same style that I made from the last lure, which I realized about halfway through. I made a swim bait about the same size, almost the same shape. I did make this tail, though, out of the Lexan, so that was cool. First time doing that. And I did learn a lot from this lure, but I did not do much detail, I feel like. So in the next lure video I make, it is going to be a big lure and it's going to have a lot of carving. I want to carve all the scales, actually carve the scales, not just paint them on like this. Carve the scales, carve the gills, carve around the eyes, the mouth, carve everything. So that is what we're doing in the next video. I want to get better at carving, so that's the plan. But guys, I hope y'all enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will catch y'all in the next one. Peace.